I'm Lynn Goldstein, a registered dietitian. You've got more calcium in your body than any other mineral. 99% of it is stored in the teeth and bones, where the body uses that calcium to build them and keep them strong. The remaining 1% of the body's calcium is in the blood, muscle, and the fluid between cells, where it helps muscle and blood vessels to contract and expand, cells to secrete hormones and enzymes, and nerves to communicate. Even though calcium is essential for healthy functioning, it's a mineral. That means the body can't actually make it, so all the calcium we need has to come from the food we eat. Smart choices for foods rich in calcium include dairy products, like low-fat or non-fat milk, cheese, and yogurt, dark green leafy vegetables, like bok choy, kale, and broccoli, and calcium-fortified foods, like some orange juice, breakfast cereals, breads, soy, and rice beverages, and tofu products. Certain nuts, like almonds, some fish, beans, and even oatmeal, also contain significant amounts of calcium. You can also get calcium from certain antacids and dietary supplements if lactose intolerance or some other factor limits your ability to get enough calcium just from meals. Despite all the different kinds of foods that contain calcium, a lot of experts still don't think we get enough of it. Recommendations for daily calcium intake vary by age, gender, and activity level, but adults need about 1,000 milligrams a day. That's about 8 ounces of low-fat yogurt, 3 ounces of fish, like sardines or salmon, 1/2 cup of soybeans, and 1/2 cup of spinach, all eaten over the course of a day. As we get older, particularly women over 50 and men over 70 need more, about 1,200 milligrams a day. Research had shown that foods high in vitamin D, when eaten in combination with calcium-rich foods, help the body absorb that calcium. That's because the body needs vitamin D to form enough of the hormone calcitriol, also called the active vitamin D. Without enough vitamin D, the body can't absorb enough calcium. Alternatively, certain ingredients, when consumed at the same time as calcium-rich foods, seem to reduce calcium absorption. These include caffeine and alcohol. When your body needs more calcium and is not getting it from the foods you're eating, it turns to the long-term storage facility, its own skeleton. Over time, this calcium depletion will lead to bone loss and crippling of the body's ability to repair and form strong new bone. This is called osteoporosis. Postmenopausal women are especially vulnerable, and so they need to be particularly mindful about getting enough calcium. Other groups that need more calcium include children, female athletes who exercise to the point that their menstruation ceases, and vegans because they avoid dairy altogether. I always remind my patients that in addition to getting enough calcium, weight-bearing exercise is essential for healthy bones, especially as we get older when bones tend to become more brittle and weak. And children benefit from bone-building exercise too. Fun options include walking, jogging, tennis, field hockey, jumping rope, basketball, dancing, hiking, weightlifting, and soccer. Be active at every age and get enough calcium by eating a rainbow of nutritious foods. Now that advice is essential.